This is Sumitha, working in PMO team as Senior Project Coordinator and Analyst at Fingent.
Hi Sumitha, welcome to Vox Populi. We have received three questions from our fellow Fingentites. And the first question is from Parvati. What's your initial reaction when a team member slips up on a critical commitment or misses a deadline? As a PMO member, will you hold yourself accountable?
I'll have a shock of my life. But jokes apart, yes, I will have to be accountable and take that ownership on behalf of my project team. But being a PMO member also brings up that responsibility where I have to proactively manage and communicate effectively within my team so that I understand these kind of risks and plan on these mitigation plans much ahead. So I should be the first among the members who are aware about, you know, such a deadline that is going to be get missed in a future date. So to have that effective communication from the team, you have to have a constant communication where you track the progress and see what is going on, and you have to be on top of things with all the project team. But the team also should have that kind of a trust and confidence in me where they come up to you and talk about a future deadline that is going to be missed and what is the impediment there, how we can plan together as a team to mitigate such risks. So I think I would want to be, or I will be such a PMO member who will be friendly and where people could be, could come up to me and talk about their problems in the project. So if I am not able to do it, so I think I should be accountable. And meanwhile, I'll be also sensitizing the team on to avoid such kind of a project risk in future. So yeah, I have to be taking that accountability and ownership on my shoulders. Yes. Yeah.
We have our next question from Amrita. How does your role model influence you on the opportunities you got for handling the projects as a project coordinator and analyst in Fingent?
Okay, good question. So to be a role model is a great leadership trait for me. I've been blessed to have been worked with lot of such role models or mentors during my career. So I've learned multiple things from all of them. So the knowledge that they have, and how they collect the knowledge, how they acquire that knowledge, to work on their projects or work on their tasks, and how that knowledge brings that confidence in them to deal the clients and deal the team, that has always mesmerized me. And another trait that I have really liked about my role models on how they show that empathy towards the customers to identify their problems. And then another thing is the respect that as my role models, how they respect their project team, the work that they do, appreciate them, motivate them. So these are few things that I have always learned from my role models by observing them, and I've tried to practice it in my projects and within my teams. So if you have that openness to learn from others and have that confidence in you to apply that knowledge into your project, I think that can really empower you a lot and help you to embark on your opportunities and really shine well, especially at Fingent. Yes.
We have our final question from Nimisha. What if you were asked to keep quiet for a whole day and you have zero access to any means of communication, including hand gestures? Will you survive? If yes, how?
It will be very difficult for you, Nimisha, not me, if I am keeping quiet. But I think on a working day, it will be a little difficult for me to be quiet and not interacting with anybody and not using any communication. But on a holiday, I guess it will be fine because I can just listen to my favorite music and just relax and sleep if I'm tired of listening to music. But Nimisha, if you're up for some kind of, some kind of a challenge, keep quiet challenge, I am up for it, and maybe I get some prizes.